So now I'll turn to Rudra Chatterjee. Rudra, of course, is the senior vice president for the Indian Chamber of Commerce, but more importantly on the ground, you run a carpet and a tea company, which are very focused on exports. So where do you see, as a corporate person, where do you see the economy right now, and what are the concerns you have?
Thanks, Promit. Thanks for the comments from Professor Panagaria and Mr. Yokoyama. The concerns that were voiced in an overall positive picture was in private investment. And that is the area where we live and operate in. And while when you look at the medium to long term, companies have grown rapidly. Many of the companies have sizably increased their business, Indian companies. But over the last few years, there have been both global and domestic issues that the companies are grappling with. My experience in the tea company, where the big demand is domestic, is muted demand, both in urban and rural areas. And this has led to lower investments for growth. There seems to be many companies in the FMCG sector, and which is a mainstay in the Indian economy, the internal consumption, where there's excess capacity. There's huge pricing pressure. And that means that while there is money available through internal generation because of profitable years in the past, there are not that many investable opportunities for these companies. For the export business, many in the audience are in that field, and there has been both this year the global growth rate. As our president spoke in the beginning, the global growth rate is picking up, but we've come through since 2008, 10 years of very, very sluggish growth, despite immense asset buildup by central banks. That slow global growth and lots of technological changes, for example, in the carpet business, we fight machine-made competition from different countries. And that has made the environment difficult. But also, there are many things that, while, as Professor Panagaria said, and, I read the Times of India report, the World Bank talks about India growing at 7.3% in the next year, and praise the ambitious leadership that is carrying out comprehensive long-term reform. But there are areas which have been difficult and continue to be difficult. For example, we all know, and successive governments, starting from the Vajpayee government, the Manmohan Singh government, and the current Modi government, have spoken about the labor reform, the need for labor reform. But even today, the total number of Indians who pay provident fund is 4.5 crore in a country with a population of over 100 crores. The total number of taxpayers is 6.26 crores. The challenge of that is the focus. The labor laws are focused on the current people who are working, making sure that they are difficult to remove from employment. But I think the opportunity lies in a young country with a huge labor pool, that it makes us easier to hire people for initially, orders that we receive from customers, we cannot guarantee that they are permanent. We need to react whenever there's an order and manufacture that product. And if they're permanent, obviously, we want to keep the workers. But if they're not, we cannot be saddled with that. Similarly, when it comes to issues like land reform, I will only speak from my experience, which is in the tea business. The tea industry has millions of hectares of land. the industry has changed. It has changed several times. The kind of tea that was produced converted from, you know, orthodox tea to CTC tea, so the production increased. Africa started producing tea. Small growers, small farmers started producing tea. So supply has tremendously increased. There are a lot of tea company owners, and it's the same with jute. They own land they would rather use for other purposes, but regulations stop that from happening. And there has to be a process of exiting one industry and getting into another. So that is the, you know, significant challenge. We see great opportunity, the massive consumption base, the growth rate of Indian economy, the world economy is also picking up. I think Indian businesses are very competitive in the global environment in all the industries that I see, which becomes a challenge. And another issue is, you know, all the reforms that happen over years, these are necessary reforms, you know, and business is only one part of society. But those reforms come as exogenous shocks to business, unanticipated exogenous shocks. And, you know, given how challenging the environment is already, you know, business has to, you know, it's essentially reel from one shock to another. And this has been the case for, you know, for decades. And that is, you know, my input.
Okay. So last person on this round, Dr. Devendra Pant from